So it's screening for that as well. We hold ourselves where we want the experience for our client and for the VA to feel like they're in an office, even though their office is Zoom. So screening for background noises, do they have a door that they can close, a window that they can close? Like, is it an actual office type setup there? And then the third piece is the work
Hello,
experience.
You're listening just like to anybody, Ready, right? Set, Go, at, like, Real Estate Investing Podcast.
Where have they been before?
By
what brands have they worked for?
This
do they have a call center experience? Do they have sales experience, business development experience? And we screen from there. So between the personality profiling, the communication evaluation, and then the resume evaluation, that then and kind of sorts them based
Thank you
on
for listening and enjoy.
Welcome back, everyone, to Ready, Set, Go, Real Estate Investing Podcast. I'm your host, Mr. Brandon Elliott. I'm excited today. We're going to be covering the nitty gritty stuff, right? The stuff to actually build a business, to build a company. There is a team, there's a village, there's a whole arsenal of not just resources, but the people, right? The culture and how to be able to build that up. It takes time. It takes energy. It takes a lot of the know-how. And if you're just getting started, then you might raise your hand saying, Brandon, I have no idea how to get all the things that I need to get done in one day. I look at Elon Musk and say, how the hell is he doing all these things and having all these successful companies? Well, he has good people in the right places. And so Greg is joining us today. He's going to be covering with his business. They've been in business for 5.5 years. He's one out of three partners. Some of the other partners have been in business 11 plus years doing exactly this, helping real estate investors of all shapes and sizes be able to really get the VA staffing that they need. So to be able to hire on your next VA, to be able to outsource and delegate a lot of this work and tedious task that can be done from another professional anywhere around the world. And it can be super affordable in so many different cases, especially when you hire on these guys to be able to handle all the SOPs, the personality test, to be able to get people locked in and make sure it's a right fit for your team so that you can start delegating. So without further ado, what's happening, Greg? How are you today?
Yeah, Brandon, thanks so much for having us on. It's a lovely day here in Dallas as we race towards summer. I'm, you know, mildly panicked. I just realized we've got a month till the kids are out of school. And it's like, what the heck are we going to do with them? But cannot complain, my man. We appreciate you having us on for the crew that tunes into your stuff every week.
Yeah, man. Appreciate you. So anybody out there that doesn't know more about who you are, as well as the team at Rocket Station, do you mind just kind of giving that 30,000 foot view?
Yeah, no, definitely. So my name's Greg Brooks. So I'm the Chief Growth Officer here at Rocket Station. So I handle everything kind of on our client success side, everything from the marketing to the sales to the placement and implementation of virtual assistants with real estate professionals like yourself, like your listeners. So we at Rocket Station, we really pride ourselves on understanding there's tons of VAs through COVID. Number one, we all kind of became VAs, right? Everybody working remote, working from home, figuring out this Zoom office that we all now own, whether we like it or not. But really helping people navigate how to hire, but specifically how to hire virtual talent the right way. I mean, there's a reason at huge companies, HR people get paid a heck of a lot of money because human capital is usually the most difficult part of every business. And we really feel like for real estate investors, regardless of where you're at, just getting going, you know, maybe this is the second or third podcast you've listened to or Facebook you've tuned into, and you're just thinking, okay, I want to try to get my first deal. Or if you're doing 30, 50, 100 deals a month, like some of our clients, we feel like virtual assistants can be a huge resource, whether you're trying to, like you said, free yourself up from some of like the mundane everyday stuff that is real estate investing, or if you're trying to grow your business and scale it to that next level, do your next million, $10 million, $100 million in transactions. When done the right way, virtual assistants can really be that jet fuel to help your business, you know, really explode and go to the direction that you want to be, as well as the entrepreneur, get you in the seat that you're best at, right? One of my partners, Rob, who started the company about 11 years ago, he was an investor in Dallas, and he kind of his calling card and what even gave him the idea of starting a virtual staffing company was the fact that he's like, dude, I'm a visionary. I'm an entrepreneur. I'm a go-getter. All that day-to-day operations, right? Whether it's like vetting deals, due diligence, follow up with our leads, right? All the way through to like the dispositions and the paperwork and the CRM management. He's like, I was good at sales. I was great at finding deals and getting in front of sellers. and getting their signature on that contract. But all that other stuff that I very quickly found out is just as important as being able to find a deal, I wasn't good at, I didn't want to do, and it was holding my business back. So what we try to do is give our clients a real turnkey solution to not only build a process-driven business, and I know we'll go into that a lot, you know, something that's scalable, whether you want to be a lifestyle investor where you just want to do a few deals a month, but you want to be on vacation 150 days a year, or if you want to be doing 20, 30, 50 transactions a month and building a big team, we help our clients build those systems and processes so they can start getting that work off their plate or off their key team members' plates and onto the plates of really talented virtual assistants. And then we also take care of, like I mentioned, that unsexy stuff that goes with HR, the talent, the vetting, all the tricks to the trade that come with hiring somebody offshore in another country. We've got almost 2,000 employees in the Philippines. So there's a certain nuance in just finding good talent wherever you are. And we handle all of that in the background so you, the client, can be put in the seat to help grow your business, help take the next step, help enjoy the entrepreneurial journey without having to get stuck in all the minutia of growing and scaling teams that I know a lot of your listeners probably can relate to.
Oh, yeah, of course. You know, I think a great book for any entrepreneur to really, a business owner to dive deep into is the book Traction, and the whole EOS kind of selection from that. I think it really breaks down and gives more clarification of, are you a visionary? Are you an integrator? Like, and you got all these ideas possibly, and you're trying to figure out how to be able to grow this business. Well, maybe if you're just starting out, you know, you do have to bootstrap it at first and kind of just, you know, play all roles of the business. But as you start growing, you start bringing in some income. And this is how I always look at it. When you are broke and you don't have any money and there's no money coming in, then you have all the time in the world, right? Typically. Yeah. Right. And then as you actually start making money, then some of these nuances and some of the chaos just starts getting more and more, because now you have to deliver, you have to, whatever the service is, right? So it starts getting busy. And it's a good thing because you start having money coming in, but now you're getting busy. So how do you actually start getting some of that time back? You start delegating, you start getting, you know, the right butts in the right seats. And the cool part is it can be a brand new person, or it could be somebody that's well established with 100 employees right now in the US that you start looking at it like, hey, maybe we can get rid of half of the selection and save a ton of money, you know, and maybe we can just have people that are, you know, in different areas around the world and so forth to kind of delegate some of this versus having people in the office have a building and all this other structure.
Yeah, I know, like the term like hustlepreneur, right? A lot of us, when we get into real estate, it's like, we're just a hustler. Like we can, and being a hustlepreneur is great. It's an incredible trait to have until you've been a hustlepreneur for a year, 2 years, 5 years, right? It wears you out. It's, you start to not enjoy the fruits of what real estate investing can bring you. So that's what we really love, right? It's whether you're just getting started and it's like, I can't afford to pay somebody $80,000 to go do this job that I suck at. VAs, we can plug them in and we can find you someone who's way more affordable to help you staff faster. Or if you've got a team built around you, you know, that you're looking to maximize your A and B level players, boom, we can help you develop systems and processes to get, I mean, we all know, like, real estate, closing the deal, the adrenaline rush that comes with that, getting that contract in hand, selling, you know, just doing the disposition on it, that's exciting. But there's a lot, just like any business, right? The in-between A to Z, it's a lot of repetitive task-based operations that are just perfect to leverage virtual assistants to automate that so that you can really be the best in your business and enjoy real estate, right? So many people burn out of real estate really quick when they get into it and really see the work that goes into it. VAs can be an incredible tool to help you, you know, maintain that journey and really build the business of your dreams.
I love that. So talk to me, when it comes down to hiring on virtual assistants, like, what does the process look like? Because, as you know, some fear that a lot of people end up, I believe, start coming up with, I know back in the day, that was something for me. I was like, how do I actually find this person? How do I go through the 10, 20 different applicants that are, you know, saying that they can work with me and do the best? And then afterwards, after I hire them on as a visionary person myself, I'm just like, hey, here's the thing that I want you to do, like, run with it. That doesn't work out that well for somebody that's doing the integration, you know, for many people, right? So it's the right knowing the personality test, how they best work, all these different moving pieces, how do you actually come up with SOPs of guiding them to success?
Yeah.
You know, like there's so many moving pieces. So what would you say to that entrepreneur that's looking to hire on their virtual assistant and something that you guys specialize in?
Yeah, definitely. And this kind of goes with, like I said, whether you work with us or even if you're like, hey, I want to try this and I want to try it myself, right? Real estate investors were glutton for punishment when it's like, hey, I can figure this out. So we break it into three key steps. There's the discovery phase, there's the process mapping and documentation phase, and then there's the onboarding and management phase. And kind of what each of those mean, with working with a company like us at Rocket Station, we do all this for you. So when you're talking about like finding this person, going through hundreds of resumes for the job I just posted, figuring out how I'm going to pace all of our people in the Philippines. So figuring out how I'm going to pay someone in Filipino pesos, we handle all that where you don't ever have to worry about it. It's, hey, you set up your account. Every 2 weeks, the money comes out of your account and goes into the VA's account. So in terms of working with us, we take care of all of it. But things to consider for those of you that are looking like, hey, maybe I want to try hiring a VA myself. First step is that discovery phase. So what I mean by discovery is it's understanding what do you need to get off your plate, right? And it doesn't need to be a lot. The great, you know, the great world that we live in with remote work and VAs, like it can be a couple hours a week. Like if all you can afford is $50 a week right now, but it's like, hey, if I could just get managing my calendar and sending my text blasts off of my plate, that would put real time back into my pocket, right? So don't think it has to be this big full-time position where they've got 20 different responsibilities. And candidly, if you're doing it yourself for the first time, I would highly encourage people, don't do that. We call them the, and I'll keep it PG for the people on Facebook, we call it the oh shoot moments.
Yeah.
What you need a VA for is your oh shoot moments. Oh shoot, I forgot to follow up with that buyer. Oh shoot, I didn't update the CRM. Oh shoot, I don't want to do that because I want to enjoy the beach with my kids this weekend, right? Those are the immediate things that can be very impactful for an entrepreneur to step in. So that discovery, it's really like, if you're doing it yourself, you sitting down with yourself or at Rocket Station, we've got a team that takes that deep dive into your business to understand like, where are those gaps? Like where are you not the person that should be doing that job? Where are you the person who it's just not worth your time to be doing it as the business owner? And we kind of start building that initial task list for you and compiling it so that we can start screening for candidates that we've already trained, vetted, and evaluated. So discovery is always first. Don't ever go into it. Brandon, and you probably know this, Brandon, because you're in the same circles I am. So often VAs are sold. You remember the old like Staples commercials where it was like, that was easy. Like that was easy. Yeah. Like so often VAs in real estate masterminds and on Facebook, on these groups, it's like, just get a VA. They'll save your life. Just get a VA. And that is true. But getting a VA without a plan for what you want that VA to do is just a waste of time and money. And it doesn't matter if it's a $3, $10, $20 an hour VA. I mean, that's cheap relative to hiring here locally, but when you don't know what they're doing and you're wasting your time trying to figure out and train them and show them stuff, time's the real valuable asset here. So it's like, don't jump in before you go through that initial discovery to really flush out like, okay, where are like three areas of impact or jobs or tasks that I could hand off to this person that would really help me as the entrepreneur or help my team immediately level up to that next, you know, the next iteration of where I feel like I got to be.
Yeah, that's good. I love that. Yeah. I mean, at the end of the day, really understanding all the moving pieces, like it's so important to put on the next hat as the business owner of leading properly. And so SOPs was something that for some odd reason, I was just getting stumped every time of, you know, how the hell do I get, you know, paint the picture of what I do during this task that I want to outsource. And it really doesn't need to be that complicated. You can even just like take every 5-10 minutes, like write down what you do for a couple of days and then kind of just get somebody to put that together. But in a lot of our businesses, we, you know, a wholesaling business, a fix and flip business, a lot of that can already be, you know, kind of tailored together. Like, God, you can use ChatGPT to, you know, in 2 seconds, give you an SOP for really any task out there. And then you just go through it and 90% of the work's done. You just start customizing it towards your business. So I think there's a lot of power behind outsourcing by all means. I'm a big advocate of outsourcing, but it comes down to how do you lead them? How do you set them up for success? And then I'm also a big believer in going through personality tests, so that you can just make sure that they are the right person for the right seat. Like they're going to be fulfilled, right? And so do you guys do any type of personality tests as well? Yeah, definitely. Any tests, besides that, to make sure that they're the right fit?
Yep. So every VA, and I'll give you some numbers. So every month, our team in the Philippines, so we have about 250, we call them Rocketeers, but basically Rocket Station team members working for us, helping on the fulfillment side, finding great talent, training that talent, and then managing them to success. So what that team does, we have a three-point inspection process for any candidate that comes in. Number three on that list is personality profiling. So we use a platform that we love. It's called Culture Index. I mean, very similar, right? Whether it's DISC, Predictive Index, Myers-Briggs, they all kind of do the same thing. I know in different circles, certain people like certain ones, but we really like Culture Index. So we do a three-point inspection. So the Culture Index piece is big. Like, who are you innately? What motivates you? Are you more of a team player? Are you more of like an individual goal getter? You know, that's a big part of what we do. Another big part, because we do a lot in the investing space, a lot of it is communication, right? Whether talking to buyers and sellers, navigating the acquisitions process, the dispo process, communication is huge. So a big part of our evaluation as well is not just communication from like English proficiency, right? For those of your listeners that maybe are like, well, how does someone in a Southeast Asian country in the Philippines speak English? English is the primary language there. So it's kind of like any major city, like the closer you are to Metro Manila, where there's all these, you know, we were just there 2 weeks ago. I mean, you've got JP Morgan buildings, Citigroup, like just, you know, just works. Like, you've got all of these major brands there. So kind of the closer you are to Metro Manila, the less you have accents, the more Americanized they are from a workforce standpoint, because they've worked for these major brands for 5, 10, 15 years. So wow. Communication is always key for us. We really pride ourselves, because we do a lot of cold calling, property management division of our business. We do a lot on like the maintenance lines, like a lot of customer interactions or potential seller interactions. So that's always number two for us. And that's something for anybody, like I said, I try to give a playbook here, looking to hire themselves. Don't hire someone just off a piece of paper. Like, have them send you a video recording, send them a sample like reading, like so that you can hear them, like a sample script that they can read and send to you, meet with them on Zoom. The other big thing that we screen for on the communication side, and for anybody who's worked with VAs overseas, living in a city is not necessarily like living in a city here in the States. And what I mean is, your neighbor might have chickens. There might be, you know, your neighbor might have a lot of dog, right? Like, and we all kind of experienced that when we went to work from home. It's like, oh, baby's crying. My puppy, I had to take over his room, and now he sleeps here and barks. So it's screening for that as well. We hold ourselves where we want the experience for our client and for the VA to feel like they're in an office, even though their office is Zoom. So screening for background noises, do they have a door that they can close, a window that they can close? Like, is it an actual office type setup there? And then the third piece is the work experience, just like anybody, right? We look at like, where have they been before? What brands have they worked for? Do they have a call center experience? Do they have sales experience, business development experience? And we screen from there. So between the personality profiling, the communication evaluations, and then the resume evaluation, that then kind of sorts them based on, are they going to be a salesperson, customer service rep? Are they a data manager? Are they a CRM manager? And we put them into specialized real estate training at that point to then, number one, give them the knowledge of the real estate industry. So like, we go through training on like, what's the difference between like wholesaling, fix and flip, wholetailing, creative finance, like giving them all that jargon and the industry knowledge to fast track the understanding of their future client's business, right? Just that kind of baseline foundation. But then we also use that to further evaluate, like, how good are you? Are you asking questions? Are you engaging? So like, all those checks and balances, which I would encourage everyone to have a plan for and be able to provide that type of training to your VA, or come work with a service provider like us, because we have 150 graduates that go through all of this before we ever even assign them into our client's business.
Now, is there a deal breaker when it comes down to, you know, if the chickens next door are going crazy, or, you know, the dog's barking, whatever it may be?
Oh, definitely. I mean, I will say there are some incredible headsets now that you could literally be screaming right beside somebody and the headset wouldn't even pick it up. So technology has definitely helped us. But yeah, no, it's a no conversation. Like, if you're on an interview, we do 3 live interviews prior to putting them into our training pool. So if at any time there's any issues, if when they're going through training, they go through a month and a half of training, if there's ever any background noise, it's something that we constantly monitor. We use some technology and AI to listen for it. So it's automated on our side from a recruitment standpoint. I mean, we obviously give the opportunity, like, hey, we like you. Everything we've seen, you're going to be successful, you're going to be awesome, but like, that can't happen. So can you find another area to work? Is there another area in your house that you can change your office to? But yeah, for us, it's just, it's off-putting, right? At the end of the day, if you're on the phone with someone trying to get their house under contract, all of a sudden you hear six chickens in the background, it's like, oh, call center. Like our perfect experience for our clients is we want your virtual assistant to look, act, and feel like they're sitting right beside you in Dallas or New York or Memphis or Boise. So yeah. When there's chickens in the background, that's very off-putting and can, you know, cost you a deal. So we're huge sticklers on that and have like a no tolerance policy there.
And then for the training period, as they go through kind of the Rocket Station with you guys, what does that look like? You said it 3 to 4 weeks, 1 month.
Yeah, exactly. So it starts as that foundational knowledge, right? So Based on kind of giving you a little peek behind the curtain, based on if they have like a customer service background or more of a sales background or more of like a data management background, we kind of know based on the industries we service, so real estate investors, property managers, like where that type of skill set will probably land. So we do the first couple of weeks is like foundational real estate knowledge, right? We draw this pretty little circle where it's like, whether you're an agent and broker or a real estate investor, these people acquire real estate, whether to live on, you know, live for or put their clients into, or, you know, sell and buy for the sake of commerce. Then investors need property managers. And here's what a property manager does. And then property managers, they leverage home service companies to maintain these properties. So we the first 2 weeks is really like introduction to the world of real estate through that kind of complete circle of like acquiring, managing, and upkeep. And then based on whether they were a salesperson or a customer service person or a data person, we put them into more specialized training to go a little bit deeper into like the actual jobs that they might be doing, like cold calling, running text blast, being a virtual lead manager, acquisitions, dispositions. We start to specialize their training, and everything we're doing, every 4 days, they get a test based on the prior learnings, whether it was like a classroom learning where they have an instructor, or if it's like self-paced learning where they've done portals or you know, reviewed call recordings. Everything's getting evaluated and they have to hit certain standards to progress to the next step in their training. So it's all kind of foundation coming down a little bit more niched. And then the final step of that is once they graduate from our training, then the client, and something I'm sure we'll get into, the process mapping, we've documented our client's processes for the role that the VA is going to fill. So the final step of that is them then meeting the client, being interviewed, being selected, and leveraging those custom built process docs for the client's business and the role that they need to really have a firm understanding of exactly what their job is going to be for the foreseeable future with the client they get selected by.
So they'll see the SOPs, they'll meet with the new client, their new boss, and then it's kind of, is that where the separation kind of ends with you guys? Or if there's any issues in the next 30, 60, 90 days, or even longer, the boss can kind of reach back out to you guys, say, hey, we need a replacement. This guy has to go, or whatever that looks like. Do you guys handle the firing?
Yeah. You mentioned it. All real estate investors are great trainers and great managers, right? That's their calling card. Like, no, they're not. So with us, we stay with our clients the entire way. The great part about our business model is the time that we spend with the client, literally building and documenting and pulling out all those processes for how they run their business out of their heads and turning it into process flowcharts, SOPs, checklists, scripts. Because we have that, not only does that empower the virtual assistant to come in, train quickly, understand their KPIs, their metrics, know what the expectations are, but it also allows our management team to effectively manage that virtual assistant to those expectations. The problem with a lot of And this may resonate with you. I know it's almost kind of a hurdle we have to get over because a lot of other VA companies in the space, management is exactly what you just said. It's okay, here's your VA. Call me when they suck. I'll get you a new one. And it's like, that's not management. But that comes down to the fact that the client doesn't have processes. The VA is having to be manually trained. The manager doesn't have any idea what the heck the VA is doing outside of, hey, they're a cold caller. So because we literally take that deep dive and partner with the client and help them build that foundational documentation so the hire can be successful, we then take the next step and assist in management of it. So each of our clients has an assigned manager who works alongside the VA. Our managers typically handle about 10 to 15 clients, but they assist in that initial training through the first 30, 60, and 90 days with the client. They're also there managing kind of the day-to-day operations based around, you know, the expectations that we set in the beginning. So it's real value, right? Because having a VA is great. Having to spend 3, 4, 5 hours with them 2, 3, 4 times a week to get them calibrated, sucks really bad. So
not really as fun.
Exactly. So when I say we really help you conceptualize what you need and then hand it off to the VA, it's a true handoff. It's not a handoff to go babysit the person and have to micromanage them for the next 2 months, 3 months, 4 months. It's a true handoff where our management can help get them up to speed quickly.
I love it. Well, that's awesome, man. Greg, talk to me about the real thing that matters here. What is the investment involved to be able to have all this stuff done for you and really set it up for success?
Yeah, definitely. So for process mapping and implementation, typically it's for our clients to onboard. So to go from that initial discovery call through process mapping to then be hiring your VA and starting typically takes about 2.5 weeks. So for the process mapping and implementation, it's a one-time onboarding of typically $19.95. Any listeners that mention your name, if they want to sign up for a call and find out more, we have a $500 discount that we're going to extend your way for having us on the pod. So it's
I knew my name would be worth some money one day.
$500.
That name, Brandon Elliott, it saves you $500, guys. So
exactly. So be sure. We'll give some information here at the end. I'm sure we'll have some in the show notes. But yeah, just mention Brandon Elliott, and you'll get $500 off. So basically, for complete process mapping for your initial hire, if you come back to us, what typically happens is a lot of clients say they hire a cold caller. And then they're like, hey, I need a lead manager. I need someone to help with dispo. I need someone to help with transaction. If we hire more VAs, we'll still put you through that same process mapping to scope out the work, but there's no extra fee. So one time, $1,495 to get going. That's good for the lifetime of the account from process and management standpoint. And then when you hire the VA, we do dedicated staffing. So your VA is not working for any other clients. So they only work for you, which really allows them to become the expert. So a full-time 40-hour-a-week VA, fully dedicated, is $10 flat rate per hour. And then if you need the flexibility of part-time, we can build a job that's anywhere from 20 to 35 hours a week if you need some flexibility. And that's just a little bit more. That's $12 flat rate an hour, billed in arrears, no payroll taxes, no liability, none of that stuff. Flat rate, just like you pay any of your subscriptions to your CRM. We bill you twice a month and it's nice and easy.
Cool. I love it. Greg, tell everybody how they can get a hold of you.
Definitely. So say anybody who wants to redeem Brandon's name for some money, go check us out at discovery.rocketstation.com. I've got my team of implementation experts there. Even if you just want to try to build that initial task list and you say you want to take that and go hire yourself, totally fine. Leverage our team. Let us bring some value to you and make it a little bit easier. So discovery.rocketstation.com. Make sure you mention Brandon's name when you sign up for that call. And then anyone just looking for some more general information, rocketstation.com is the website. We got tons of free giveaways, checklists, example SOPs, if you're kind of new to this and want to kind of learn a little bit more. And then my email is brooks@rocketstation. So feel free to reach out with any questions you might have.
Love it. Appreciate you, brother. Yeah, man, I got a ton of notes right here. I'm excited for everybody that is in that position and like they need to start delegating. Trust me, we have 14 employees at this point that are helping. And then there's the list goes on of certain ones that have their own VAs. I think we're at like 20 something that are helping out in total. And that's just think about it like this, like you getting all excited to how much like, you know, you look back at the end of the day and see how much you got done as one individual. Can you imagine if you guys are all on point, there's multiple of you and you guys are just all crushing it each and every day, how much you can look back a month down the road or 6 months or 12 months and see how much you guys have accomplished as a company, as a business, as a brand, and just the impact that you make along the way as well. It's incredible. So I highly, 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 highly encourage you to reach out to Greg and Rocket Station. It's an amazing resource for you guys. And I told you guys, my name would mean something. My mom always said, you know, it would be something one day. So $500, well, you guys can save that and be able to jump in and make it even more affordable for you. But with that being said, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you get the newest notification every Monday when the new episode drops. Leave that 5-star review. Love you guys all. Appreciate you. If you guys are looking for some credit education, learning how to get up to $500,000 in new credit lines at 0% interest every 6 months, you can do this. Then check out creditcounselelite.com. That is www.creditcounselelite.com. Don't leave the money on the table. You'll be able to get a lot of it. So we'll see you next time, guys. Till next time, God bless. Greg, appreciate you, man.
Thank you, brother.
This has been another episode of Ready, Set, Go! Real Estate Investing Podcast, brought to you by Brandon Elliott. For more more information, please visit BrandonElliottInvestments.com. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and leave a comment below. Thanks again for joining. Until next time, God bless.